In this video, I'll be demonstrating the anatomy of iliopsoas muscle. But if I be more specific, these iliopsoas can be divided two muscles, which is psoas major and iliacus. These two muscles are very important for hip movement and trunk movement. Let's look at one by one. Let's look at iliacus here. Iliacus originates from inside part of ilium, which is pelvis here, and runs like this way. It passes anterior part of hip joint and it attaches here. This bony bump is called lesser trochanter. This is greater trochanter, and this part is lesser trochanter. So iliacus originates from inside of ilium, then inserts into lesser trochanter. The function of iliacus is mainly hip flexion, and it moves pelvis as well. So let's go to psoas. Psoas originates from mainly lumbar spine. You know, it originates from spine, then it runs like this, then it kind of fuses with iliacus here. Then it attaches on lesser trochanter as well. You see this part, iliacus and psoas kind of fuses together. That's why these muscles are called iliopsoas. So the function of psoas is also hip flexion, like iliacus. But what's different from iliacus is psoas originates from lumbar spine. So psoas moves lumbar spine. What is that about? So iliacus originates from ilium, pelvis, so it moves pelvis. But psoas originates from spine, so it moves spine. So this is very important differences in between two muscles. So more thing about psoas. Psoas does either flexion or extension of lumbar spine. It depends on your trunk position. Flexion or extension. Extension is this way. Flexion is this way. Depends on your position. And if one side of psoas contract, it does side bend and rotation. Side bend, rotation. If one side of psoas contracts, it does side bend and rotation. If it contracts bilaterally, which means both sides, this does extension or flexion. It's very important for core mobility and core stability. One thing you have to be careful when you treat psoas or when you do stretch for psoas, remember, psoas originates from very inside of trunk. You see, there is a core muscle here, like rectus abdominis, or external oblique, internal oblique. And here, there is internal organs here, like small intestine, large intestine, the kidney, here, then. Deep to internal organs, there's psoas. That's why this is very deep muscle. When you treat psoas, like myofascial release, massage, or when you do stretch, be aware this muscle is very deep. Because this is very deep muscle, people are not aware that psoas is here. That's why so many people cannot use psoas. Why? Why not? Because this is very deep muscle. People are not aware of there is a muscle such in deep place. That's why they cannot use. So why using psoas or iliacus are so important? Because hip flexion muscles are not very strong compared to hip extensors. Hip extensors are located on back side of pelvis and hip joint. Let's say hip extensors, gluteus maximus, very big muscles, hamstrings, it's very big muscles. These muscles are big hip extensors. Compared to hip extensors, there are not many strong muscles, like rectus femoris. It's long muscle but not strong as hamstring or gluteus maximus. Let's say tensor fascia latae here, it's small muscle as well. Or sartorius here, it's very long muscle but not as strong as hamstrings. Then psoas and iliacus, not many of them. They are not strong as compared to backside. So if you cannot use psoas or iliacus, they are not involved with hip flexion. These tiny muscles have to do their job. The tiny guys have to do big movement. That's not efficient, right? So psoas and iliacus have to cooperate with hip flexion. If you can use psoas and iliacus for hip flexion, you can raise up your hip joint more efficiently compared to not using your psoas and iliacus. So that's why psoas and iliacus are very important for hip movement. And also, they are important for core movement. Iliacus for pelvic movement and psoas for lumbar movement. These two muscles are important both for hip movement and core movement. So this is today's video. If you liked it, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you in next video.